Hello guys, I'm Yao Wang and today I'm here to present animal cloning. Okay, so before we get into more complicated things, let's clear up some general knowledge. So, what are clones? Well, as you can see in the slide, there are organisms that have the exact same genetic material as the original organism that was cloned. Some examples present in nature are identical twins and plant cuttings. Now that I have explained what clones are, let's review something we learned in class that is also about cloning. Gene cloning. I trust most of you already know what gene cloning is, but in the case that you don't know what gene cloning is, it's a common practice in molecular biology that is used by researchers to create copies of a particular gene for downstream applications, such as DNA sequencing. And now, how does it work? Well, first, we take a plasmid from a bacteria. Then, we use a restriction enzyme to cut off a segment of the plasmid. Next, we take the isolated human gene, in this case, it will be the gene coding for production of insulin. After that, we glue the human DNA to the plasmid with ligase. Next, we put the plasmid back into a bacteria and let it multiply for us. And that's the process of gene cloning. So, since we're talking about clones, we have to talk about Dolly the sheep. The first sheep that was cloned in 1996, when Dr. Ian Mulmite and his group successfully cloned Dolly, therefore making science fiction achievable. So, how did they clone Dolly? Well, they used a process called somatic cell nucleus transfer, which goes like this. First, they took some sheep udder cells from the nucleus donor and put them in starvation conditions, otherwise known as the G0 state. It's when cells are in a state similar to embryonic cells. Then, they take an egg cell from another sheep, we'll call her the egg donor, and take out the nucleus. Next, we take the nucleus-free egg cell and use an electric shock from a machine called electro cell manipulator to fuse it with a starved udder cell. Now, you have an egg with the nucleus donor's genetic material. So next, they put the fused egg cell into another sheep and let it give birth to the sheep. And that's how humans cloned the first sheep. Somatic cell nuclear transfer isn't the only way to clone an animal. There's also another way called embryo splitting. Well, embryo splitting is basically splitting an embryo to create identical twins. How does it work? Well, take a sperm and an egg, fuse the two together, wait for the 16 cell embryo to form, split the 16 cell embryo into four, then put the embryos in four different surrogate mothers. So the result will be the offspring will be identical to the three other offspring, but not to the parents, like Dolly was to her nucleus donor. Now that I have finally explained both somatic cell nuclear transfer and embryo splitting, we can finally move on to the next question. Well, how have we improved? I'm not so sure, but I am sure that we can clone mice, cows, sheep, chicken, cats, deer, horses, mules, ox, monkeys, and the list goes on. But what everybody is interested in is in cloning humans, the real deal. According to scientists, if we put ethics aside, cloning a human is biologically possible. People are already cloning human embryos to make stem cells. It's not a huge gap. Although we might live long enough to experience human cloning in our lifetime, there are still some challenges scientists have to overcome before that. For example, when scientists cloned mice, researchers were able to conduct experiments with thousands of eggs. But with humans, it's a whole different story. Because human eggs aren't that easy to come by with, it makes it a precious resource. Also, when scientists cloned mice and cows, they were able to remove the nucleus of the egg cell, and with the nucleus, the proteins essential for the cell's division. However, in mice and cows, those weren't problems, because their embryo were ultimately able to make these proteins again, but with humans and primates, they aren't able to do this. If for a second we forgot what I just mentioned about human cloning and imagined that we can clone humans, would you support it or oppose it? Most people oppose it, and that's why most countries ban human cloning for now. And most people oppose it due to the ethic reasons, while the people that support human cloning think about the medical advancements. like replaceable organs that your body won't reject because you're cloning your own organ, and better understanding of the human body. While the people that oppose it think we're using the power of gods, and how there might be security issues if there are clones, and how people might not treat clones fairly. So, the next big question, how can cloning benefit us now? Well, have you ever had a pet you love pass away? No matter if it was a cat, a dog, or a bird. But what if you can have him or her back? Would you do it? Well, it's certainly possible with today's technology. For example, a company called Soan Biotech is now taking in skin samples of your dogs, and they are willing to clone him or her for you. Although there will be a fee of $100,000 you'll have to pay, but some say it's worth it to be reunited with their beloved pet. Another beneficial thing that cloning can provide us is to have organ transplants without transplant rejection, which is when you transplant someone else's organs, but then your body rejects it because it's an outside organ. So if we cloned our organ, there will be no such problem because you're putting back your own organ, so your body won't recognize this as an outside threat. If you still don't believe me, let's take a look at the statistics. Out of 100 people who get organ transplants, 3 will get damaged and rejected by the body in the first month, 7 in the first year, and 17 in the third year, and 46 in the 10th year. You may think that isn't a lot, but if you were getting a transplant, you may think otherwise. What if you were the lucky 3 that had an organ failure in the first month? After all that time getting waitlisted, you only get 1 month with a good organ. Plus, your body will get damaged after the organ is rejected. To sum up, except for human cloning, what other possibilities may there be in the future with this fantastic mating technology? One likely possibility is to use this new technology to resurrect some extinct animals. For example, the woolly mammoth, which as we speak is being researched on. Think of all the possibilities. Maybe even one day we may even resurrect a dinosaur. This will be the end of my video. Thank you for watching.